here from the Creative Eclectic. Hope you're having a really great day. I'm going to show you some embossing basics because I realised that I haven't for quite some time talked to people about the basics of embossing. And this is heat embossing, not embossing with a big shot machine. So what you need for this project is a heat tool. I'm using the Stamping Up one because it has two settings, a high and a low, and we'll be using the high setting. A Stamping Up embossing buddy. So this is basically an anti-static pillow. This is essential for heat embossing. And you need some Versamark watermark ink. Also need a stamp set. We're going to use the Colourful Seasons stamp set. And we're going to use all of the current embossing powders that are in the annual catalogue. I've already mounted my stamp on the block. We are using some watercolour paper for this project and some old olive paper, and I've also got just some plain Whisper White cardstock that's going to go on the inside of the card, so I'll put that over to one side. So let's start with the basic heat embossing. So because we're using watercolour paper, this goes for any paper that you use, you really need to use your embossing buddy, and you might see some little bits of dust come off, that's okay. And you need to rub all over your piece of cardstock with the embossing buddy. So what that does is that prevents the embossing powder from sticking where you don't want it to stick. So we're going to emboss first off in some copper, I think. Yeah, some copper would be nice. So we're using the leaf from the Colourful Seasons stamp set. You can use any stamp set that you like. Now, I like to keep my embossing powder in a little container, one for each colour, just because I find it easier. So you can't see really where the Versamark has been stamped. That's okay. I've got a little spoon here that I've got from one of our many travels, and I'm just going to sprinkle the powder onto the cardstock. Now, if you have a fine little brush, this would be a great time to get that out. I don't have one. I'm just going to wipe off the excess where I don't want it. Just flick it to get any of the powder off that you don't want. I'm going to put a bit more on and then flick it again. That's really important when you're using the photopolymer stamps to have a foam mat underneath them. I've got a foam mat underneath this cardstock, but you can use the Stamping Pierce mat. That's what most demonstrators use. I just have this bit of foam that's the same size as my grid paper. Okay. So make sure when you've got your embossing powder on that you close up your embossing powder and move it away from your heat. For two reasons, you don't want it to melt into your a big puddle, and also you don't want to knock it over and end up with embossing powder all over the house. I've done that, it's not a good idea. I'm just going to heat this up on the high setting. But you'll see that the powder's gone from that grainy looking thing to a nice copper colour. So I'm going to repeat that with the gold and the silver and the white. Actually, no, the gold and the silver embossing powder. So I'll go back to the silver. So again, wiping all over your project with the embossing buddy. I've got my silver here. Now I like to heat each colour as I do them because I don't want to mix up the colours together. So I've got my spoon, I'm just going to sprinkle my embossing powder on. Now the silver powder doesn't have a fine excess like the copper and the gold do. Let's just save time. I might actually even do the gold this time. I've got to be really careful not to mix the powders together, but that's okay. Now you can do embossing on any cardstock you like, whether it be Whisper White, Very Vanilla, Shimmery White, Glossy White, or the watercolour cardstock that we're using here. So this is my gold embossing powder. And I'm being really careful that I don't touch the silver leaf because you don't want to smudge it. Now, I must have had a bit of ghosting, Versamark ghosting there. So I'm just going to use my fingernail and just scrape that off because I don't want a big hunk of embossing powder there. It doesn't matter if it's a smudge of it, but I don't want a big blob. Okay. So I've done my silver and my gold. Again, put your lid back on and move it out the way so that's away from the heat. Now what happens when the paper heats up? Is it sometimes curls, and that's fine because what you need to do is just heat from underneath. So I've got my silver and gold and copper done. I'm just going to put that aside for a second. I've also got this strip here. I like to do all of my embossing at once because it's then I can get it out the way. And so what I'm going to do with this one is I'm going to emboss this strip, which is going to go on the inside, in white. So get out my embossing buddy, wipe all over it, try not to put your fingers in the middle of your cardstock after you've wiped with the embossing buddy, because what that does is that might make the embossing powder stick where you don't want it. So I'm going to stamp a few times on this one because I'm making a pattern. But it doesn't matter if it goes off the edge, that's exactly what I want it to do. I'm just going to put my white embossing powder on. Now, this embossing powder is fairly old. I've had it in my stash for a long time. So, yes, embossing powder does have a shelf life. It doesn't last forever. So this one's starting to smell a little bit. It shouldn't smell. I think I've had this one since before the last colour revamp about 5 or so years ago. So, because I get a little, I get a run-on on embossing. Okay. So this is my white embossing powder. Again, I'm going to put my lid on. Move it out the way. Now, because this is old, it's going to take longer to heat. So I'm just going to wipe it over with my embossing buddy again. I'll just pat it, make sure there's nothing that the embossing powder is going to stick to. And I'm just going to put a clear... Ooh! Got wet. Don't know quite how that happened. Going to put a clear I don't think my husband liked me using a tea towel, but it's okay. I forgot to say you need to move your stamps out of the way too, because if you have your stamps in the way when you're heat embossing, you could melt them. There's nothing worse than melted stamps. Okay, now we're doing the last of the embossing powder on the inside strip. I have an extra strip in case it didn't work. I haven't made this project before, so I'm hoping that it all goes to plan. So as you can see here, the clear embossing powder looks sort of a whitish grey colour. But when you heat it, it goes the same colour as your cardstock. So you can see that it's like a dark old olive. I haven't heated that bit enough. I'll just... So you have to be really careful that you don't burn the white embossing powder. Okay. Now the last thing I want to also do with this one before I start colouring it is stamp a greeting on it. So let's just put a thinking of you greeting on. Now I don't have the right colour, right size block here because I'm not in my craft room, but that's okay. So again, I'm going to use my embossing buddy, go over it as much as you can so the powder doesn't stick where you don't want it to. Now Versamark is also good at for as well as for embossing. It's good for priming your stamps before you use them, use a dark colour with the photopolymer stamps. So I'm just going to stamp the thinking of you in the bottom here. Now I've got some black embossing powder. Now this is stamping up embossing powder from when they brought out the black the last time. I never got rid of it because I loved it so much. I'm so glad that they've brought it back in again. And you'll see when you put the black on, it's very, very fine, and if you don't tap it off properly, you're going to end up with a fine black dust, and you don't want that. I'm going to okay. Now we're just going to heat the last of the embossing powders. Again, this powder's a little bit old, so it'll take a little bit longer to heat. But you'll know it's heated because it changes. It's very glossy. And I wouldn't recommend putting your fingers on it when it's hot because it can burn. I've got no feeling left in my fingers from being burnt so many times, so it doesn't really matter to me. All right, so we might just assemble the inside of the card first. So we've got a piece of Whisper White, I've got my piece of Old Olive, which is a bit bigger, a bit wider than the Whisper White, and that's so that I can just trim it off and make it the right size. I'm just going to Oh, and I've run out of adhesive. That's not very clever. Hang on, I'll just grab another one. But no, I hadn't run out of adhesive. I was trying to use it upside down. Yeah. You see, I'm an expert. So what I'm doing here is, because I tried to use it upside down, it's gotten caught on itself. So I'm just winding it up. Now it'll work fine. Okay. I'm going to use my grid lines to make sure that it's nice and straight. It's always nice to decorate the inside of your card as well. Now I could have made that a bit narrower, but I just wanted to make it that width because I wanted to carry over the pattern. I've just trimmed that off there. Okay, and put that over to one side. Now the fun bit is colouring our leaves. Now I'm just going to do a really quick watercolour thing. So I've got a stamping spritzer and I have got four colours here. So I've got crushed curry. So I've filled them with water, put about 5 to 10 re-ink drops in each. And I'm just going to spray it. Oh, not spray it on myself. And so when you spray it, just make sure that it's facing down. I've got also some Cajun Craze, which I haven't put enough re-inkers in, but that's all right. And a bit of Old Olive as well. I want a bit more yellow on there. So, as you can see, when the watercolour paper gets wet, it goes, it tries to curl up on itself. Which one that is? A bit more pumpkin pie. I'm just going to dry it off. Okay, so now my embossing's done and my watercolour paper is almost dry. So what I'm going to do is just stick the rest of the card together. So I've got my snail adhesive and instead of putting it on the watercolour paper, which is still a bit damp and it could tear, I'm going to put it directly on the base card. Just about a quarter of an inch in from the edge and a few extra bits in the middle. Now this is a fairly basic card in terms of it doesn't have a lot of embellishments, but I liked the embossing and I think that that can be considered an embellishment enough. Now, to just finish it off, I've got a Winker Stella, and I'm just going to squeeze it a bit. I've got plenty of Winker Stella on the thing, and I'm just going to flick some onto some spots onto the cardstock. Yeah, it's not. I don't want too much, just a bit. Whoops. I use Winker Stella a lot, so it's possible that it's running out. Now you'll see that the embossing makes sort of a resist effect. So that's my out front of my card. The inside of my card carries on the leaf theme from the front in the white and the clear embossing. So there you go. There are the five embossing powders that Stamping Up currently carries, all on the one project. I hope you enjoyed this project, and if there is a tip or a technique that you'd like me to demonstrate, please email me at chrissy@thecreativeeclectic.com. And I will endeavour to make a video as soon as I can. Thanks for watching. Until next time, happy stamping!